Anthony Phillips, and I've been very lucky somehow to win the Grand Design Award. So this is for the reissues series, which Esoteric have put out of my first five albums.
What does this particular honour tonight mean to you?
It means a hell of a lot, because obviously, the company in which I kept, I mean, I was taken by surprise, because there were some huge artists who I've somehow managed to pivot the post. So I think maybe there needs to be a recount. The artwork was, the remixing was all fantastic, but still it means people aren't going to buy this just because it looks nice. Obviously people must have thought they wanted to get these albums and get them again, so I'm so delighted, and I really can't believe it, actually, the truth of it. Yeah, very chuffed. I'm very chuffed for all involved.
Of course, we're at the Progressive Music Awards tonight. What for you is the true spirit, the essence of progressive music?
Well, I think there are traps with it, you know, which is it can be overblown. I think that what progressive music did at its best was to just broaden the format of music, you know, where you were just kind of trapped in verse chorus. You could argue the Beatles were starting to be progressive with the track That Day in the Life, which had a lot of different sections, and it, you know. And so I think it was the form of prog which was the main thing. Elasticating the format of music and showing that you can have a long piece with lots of different sections that still has form. It's a bit like, you know, the difference between a short story and a long novel. I mean, you can have a long piece of music that still works. Classical pieces are like that. And I think that what prog tried to do a lot of the time was to have a longer design, so you'd have a more fulfilling listen, maybe not as catchy a listen, but a more fulfilling listen, more colour, more light and shade, more dynamics, you know, perhaps more of a theatrical experience as well. And it got overblown sometimes, and I think people overreached themselves and it got a bit pompous, and that maybe put people off. But at its best, I think it was a really creative force. Well, I would hope that the younger bands just carry on from the Genesis's Yes, King Crimson, and just keep experimenting with longer. There's nothing wrong with verse chorus pop songs, don't get me wrong, you know, I love some, but there's nothing wrong also with experimenting with different forms, maybe something that lasts 4 or 5 minutes. And I just hope people carry on experimenting in a slightly more adventurous format, if you like, you know, ungoverned by the diktats of having to, you know, be played on the radio in 2 minutes, kind of thing. I'm very proud of the 5.1 surround sound remixes, because I think particularly on instrumentals, I think it really does change things. Songs you can't do so much with, but you know, if you think of when you're watching a film in the cinema with the surround sound all around you, what a much more complete experience it is. The ability with instrumentals to be able to create a complete sound canvas like that. It's lovely. Yeah, so I would be very proud of those.